Chainmail, mailarmai, also chainmaila or chainmaila, is a type of armor consisting of small metal rings linked together in a pattern to form a mesh. A coat of this armor is often referred to as a hauberk, and sometimes a burnie. The earliest example of surviving mail was found in a chieftain's burial located in Shemesht, Romania. Its invention is commonly credited to the Celts, but there are examples of Etruscan pattern mail dating from at least the 4th century BCE. Mail may have been inspired by the much earlier scale armor. Mail spread to North Africa, West Africa, the Middle East, Central Asia, India, Tibet, Southeast Asia, and Japan. Herodotus wrote that the ancient Persians wore scale armor, but mail is also distinctly mentioned in the Avesta, the ancient holy scripture of the Persian religion of Zoroastrianism that was founded by the prophet Zoroaster in the 5th century BC. Mail continues to be used in the 21st century as a component of stab-resistant body armor, cut-resistant gloves for butchers and woodworkers, shark-resistant wetsuits for defense against shark bites, and a number of other applications. The origins of the word mail are not fully known. One theory is that it originally derives from the Latin word, macula, meaning spot or opacity, ace and macula of retina. Another theory relates the word to the Old French, mailier, meaning to hammer, related to the modern English word, malleable. In modern French, mail refers to a loop or stitch. The Arabic words burnous, a burnous, a hooded cloak, also a chasuble, worn by Coptic priests, and burnaza, to bronze, suggest an Arabic influence for the Carolingian armor known as burnie, see below. The first attestations of the word mail are in Old French and Anglo-Norman, mai, mailey, or mail or other variants, which became mailey, mai, mailey, mail, or mail in Middle English. The modern usage of terms for mail armor is highly contested in popular and, to a lesser degree, academic culture. Medieval sources referred to armor of this type simply as mail, however, chainmail has become a commonly used, if incorrect, neologism first attested in Sir Walter Scott's 1822 novel The Fortunes of Nigel. Since then the word mail has been commonly, if incorrectly, applied to other types of armor, such as in plate mail, first attested in 1835. The more correct term is plate armor. Civilizations that used mail invented specific terms for each garment made from it. The standard terms for European mail armor derive from French. Leggings are called chausses, a hood is a mail coif, and mittens, mitens. A mail collar hanging from a helmet is a camail or aventail. A shirt made from mail is a hauberk if knee length and a haubergeon if mid thigh length. A layer, or layers, of mail sandwiched between layers of fabric is called a jazarin. A waist length coat in medieval Europe was called a burnie, although the exact construction of a burnie is unclear, including whether it was constructed off mail or other armor types. Noting that the burnie was the most highly valued piece of armor to the Carolingian soldier, Bennett, Bradbury, De Vries, Dickey, and Gestas indicate that there is some dispute among historians as to what exactly constituted the Carolingian burnie. Relying only on artistic and some literary sources because of the lack of archaeological examples, some believe that it was a heavy leather jacket with metal scales sewn onto it. It was also quite long, reaching below the hips and covering most of the arms. Other historians claim instead that the Carolingian burnie was nothing more than a coat of mail, but longer and perhaps heavier than traditional early medieval mail. Without more certain evidence, this dispute will continue. The use of mail as battlefield armor was common during the Iron Age and the Middle Ages, becoming less common over the course of the 16th and 17th centuries. It is believed that the Roman Republic first came into contact with mail fighting the Gauls in Cisalpine Gaul, now northern Italy, but a different pattern of mail was already in use among the Etruscans. The Roman army adopted the technology for their troops in the form of the Lorica Hamata, which was used as a primary form of armor through the imperial period. After the fall of the Western Empire, much of the infrastructure needed to create plate armor diminished. Eventually the word mail came to be synonymous with armor. It was typically an extremely prized commodity, as it was expensive and time-consuming to produce and could mean the difference between life and death in a battle. Mail from dead combatants was frequently looted and was used by the new owner or sold for a lucrative price. As time went on and infrastructure improved, it came to be used by more soldiers. Eventually with the rise of the lance cavalry charge, impact warfare, and high-powered crossbows, mail came to be used as a secondary armor to plate for the mounted nobility. By the 14th century, plate armor was commonly used to supplement mail. Eventually mail was supplanted by plate for the most part, as it provided greater protection against windless crossbows, bludgeoning weapons, and lance charges. However, mail was still widely used by many soldiers as well as brigandines and padded jacks. These three types of armor made up the bulk of the equipment used by soldiers, with mail being the most expensive. It was sometimes more expensive than plate armor. Mail typically persisted longer in less technologically advanced areas such as Eastern Europe, but was in use everywhere into the 16th century. During the late 19th and early 20th century, mail was used as a material for bulletproof vests, most notably by the Wilkinson Sword Company. Results were unsatisfactory. Wilkinson mail worn by the Khedive of Egypt's Regiment of Iron Men was manufactured from split rings, which proved to be too brittle, and the rings would fragment when struck by bullets and aggravate the injury. The riveted mail armor worn by the opposing Sudanese Mahdists did not have the same problem, but also proved to be relatively useless against the firearms of British forces at the Battle of Omdurman. During World War I, Wilkinson sword transitioned from mail to a lamellar design, which was the precursor to the flak jacket. Also during World War I, a mail fringe, designed by Captain Cruz of the British Infantry, was added to helmets to protect the face. This proved unpopular with soldiers, in spite of being proven to defend against a 3-ounce, 100 grams, shrapnel round fired at a distance of. A protective face mask or splatter mask had a chain mail veil and was used by early tank crews as a measure against flying steel fragments, spalling, in city vehicle. Mail armor was introduced to the Middle East and Asia through the Romans and was adopted by the Sassanid Persians starting in the 3rd century AD, where it was supplemental to the scale and lamellar armor already used. Mail was commonly also used as horse armor for cataphracts and heavy cavalry, as well as armor for the soldiers themselves. Asian mail could be just as heavy as the European variety and sometimes had prayer symbols stamped on the rings as a sign of their craftsmanship as well as for divine protection. Indeed, mail armor is mentioned in the Quran as being a gift revealed by Allah to David. 21:80 It was we who taught him the making of coats of mail for your benefit, to guard you from each other's violence, will ye then be grateful? Yusuf Ali's translation. From the Middle East, mail was quickly adopted in Central Asia by the Sogdians and by India in the south. Mail armor was introduced by the Turks in late 12th century and commonly used by Turk and the Mughal armies, where it eventually became the armor of choice in India. Indian mail was constructed with alternating rows of solid links and round riveted links, and it was often integrated with plate protection, mail and plate armor. Mail and plate armor was commonly used in India until the Battle of Plassey and the subsequent British conquest of the subcontinent. The Ottoman Empire used mail armor as well as mail and plate armor, and it was used in their armies until the 18th century by heavy cavalry and elite units who as the Janissaries. They spread its use into North Africa, where it was adopted by Mamluk Egyptians and the Sudanese, who produced it until the early 20th century. Ottoman mail was constructed with alternating rows of solid links and round riveted links. The Persians used mail armor as well as mail and plate armor. Persian mail and Ottoman mail were often quite similar in appearance. Mail was introduced to China when its allies in Central Asia paid tribute to the Tang Emperor in 718 by giving him a coat of link armor assumed to be mail. China first encountered the armor in 384 when its allies in the nation of Kuchi arrived wearing armor similar to chains. Once in China, mail was imported but was not produced widely. Due to its flexibility, comfort, and rarity, it was typically the armor of high-ranking guards and those who could afford the exotic import, to show off their social status, rather than the armor of the rank and file, who used more common brigandine, scale, and lamellar types. However, it was one of the only military products that China imported from foreigners. Mail spread to Korea slightly later, where it was imported as the armor of imperial guards and generals. In Japan, mail is called, which means chain. When the word kusari is used in conjunction with an armored item, it usually means that mail makes up the majority of the armor composition. An example of this would be kusari gusoku, which means chain armor. Kusari, shoulder, and other armored clothing were produced, even socks. Was used in samurai armor at least from the time of the Mongol invasion, 1270s, but particularly from the Namboku-cho period, 1336-1392. The Japanese used many different weave methods, including a square 4-in-1 pattern, sogusari, a hexagonal 6-in-1 pattern, hanagusari, and a European 4-in-1, nanbangusari. The rings of Japanese mail were much smaller than their European counterparts. They would be used in patches to link together plaits and to drape over vulnerable areas such as the armpits. Riveted kusari was known and used in Japan. On page 58 of the book Japanese Arms and Armor, Introduction by H. Russell Robinson, there is a picture of Japanese riveted kusari, and this quote from the translated reference of 1800 book, The Manufacture of Armor and Helmets in 16th Century Japan, shows that the Japanese not only knew of and used riveted kusari but that they manufactured it as well. Karakuri namban, riveted namban, with stout links each closed by a rivet. Its invention is credited to Fukushima Dembeku Nataka, pupil of Hojo Awano Kami Ujifusa, but it is also said to be derived directly from foreign models. It is heavy because the links are tinned, by Akiro Nagashi, and these are also sharp-edged because they are punched out of iron plate. Butted and or split, twisted, links made up the majority of kusari links used by the Japanese. Links were either butted together, meaning that the ends touched each other and were not riveted, or the kusari was constructed with links where the wire was turned or twisted two or more times. These split links are similar to the modern split ring commonly used on keychains. The rings were lacquered black to prevent rusting, and were always stitched onto a backing off cloth or leather. The kusari was sometimes concealed entirely between layers of cloth. Kusari gusoku or chain armor was commonly used during the Edo period 1603 to 1868 as a standalone defense. According to George Cameron Stone, entire suits of male kusari gusoku were worn on occasions, sometimes under the ordinary clothing. Ian Bottomley in his book Arms and Armor of the Samurai, The History of Weaponry in Ancient Japan, shows a picture of a kusari armor and mentions chain jackets, with detachable arms being worn by samurai police officials during the Edo period. The end of the samurai era in the 1860s, along with the 1876 ban on wearing swords in public, marked the end of any practical use for mail and other armor in Japan. Japan turned to a conscription army and uniforms replaced armor. Mail armor provided an effective defense against slashing blows by edged weapons and some forms of penetration by many thrusting and piercing weapons. In fact, a study conducted at the Royal Armouries at Leeds concluded that it is almost impossible to penetrate using any conventional medieval weapon. Generally speaking, mail's resistance to weapons is determined by four factors: linkage type, riveted, butted, or welded, material used, iron versus bronze or steel, weave density, a tighter weave needs a thinner weapon to surpass, and ring thickness, generally ranging from 18 to 14 gauge, 1.02 to 1.63 millimeters diameter, wire in most examples. Mail, if a warrior could afford it, provided a significant advantage when combined with competent fighting techniques. When the mail was not riveted, a thrust from most sharp weapons could penetrate it. However, when mail was riveted, only a strong well-placed thrust from certain spears, or thin or dedicated mail-piercing swords like the estoc could penetrate, and a poleaxe or halberd blow could break through the armor. Strong projectile weapons such as stronger self-bows, recurve bows, and crossbows could also penetrate riveted mail. Some evidence indicates that during armored combat, the intention was to actually get around the armor rather than through it. According to a study of skeletons found in Visby, Sweden, a majority of the skeletons showed wounds on less well-protected legs. Although mail was a formidable protection, due to long swords getting more tapered as time progressed, mail worn under plate armor, and standalone mail as well, could be penetrated by the conventional weaponry of another knight. The flexibility of mail meant that a blow would often injure the wearer, potentially causing serious bruising or fractures, and it was a poor defense against head trauma. Mail-clad warriors typically wore separate rigid helms over their mail coifs for head protection. Likewise, blunt weapons such as maces and warhammers could harm the wearer by their impact without penetrating the armor. Usually a soft armor, such as gambeson, was worn under the hauberk. Medieval surgeons were very well capable of setting and caring for bone fractures resulting from blunt weapons. With the poor understanding of hygiene, however, cuts that could get infected were much more of a problem. Thus mail armor proved to be sufficient protection in most situations. Several patterns of linking the rings together have been known since ancient times, with the most common being the 4-to-1 pattern, where each ring is linked with four others. In Europe, the 4-to-1 pattern was completely dominant. Mail was also common in East Asia, primarily Japan, with several more patterns being utilized and an entire nomenclature developing around them. Historically, in Europe, from the pre-Roman period on, the rings composing a piece of mail would be riveted closed to reduce the chance of the rings splitting open when subjected to a thrusting attack or a hit by an arrow. Up until the 14th century, European mail was made of alternating rows of round riveted rings and solid rings. Sometime during the 14th century, European mailmakers started to transition from round rivets to wedge-shaped rivets but continued using alternating rows of solid rings. Eventually, European mailmakers stopped using solid rings and almost all European mail was made from wedge riveted rings only with no solid rings. Both were commonly made of wrought iron, but some later pieces were made of heat-treated steel. Wire for the riveted rings was formed by either of two methods. One was to hammer out wrought iron into plates and cut or slit the plates. These thin pieces were then pulled through a draw plate repeatedly until the desired diameter was achieved. Water wheel-powered drawing mills are pictured in several period manuscripts. Another method was to simply forge down an iron billet into a rod and then proceed to draw it out into wire. The solid links would have been made by punching from a sheet. Guild marks were often stamped on the rings to show their origin and craftsmanship. Forge welding was also used to create solid links, but there are few possible examples known. The only well-documented example from Europe is that of the camail, male neck defense, of the 7th century Coppergate helmet. Outside of Europe, this practice was more common, such as the Ada links from India. Very few examples of historic butted mail have been found, and it is generally accepted that butted mail was never in wide use historically except in Japan, where mail, kusari, was commonly made from butted links. Butted link mail was also used by the Moro of the Philippines in their mail and plate armors. Mail is used as protective clothing for butchers against meat packing equipment. Workers may wear up to of mail under their white coats. Butchers also commonly wear a single mail glove to protect themselves from self-inflicted injury while cutting meat. Wood carvers sometimes use similar mail gloves to protect their hands from cuts and punctures. Scuba divers use mail to protect them from shark bite, as do animal control officers for protection against the animals they handle. Shark expert and underwater filmmaker Valerie Taylor was among the first to develop and test shark suits in 1979 while diving with sharks. Mail is widely used in industrial settings as shrapnel guards and splash guards in metalworking operations. Electrical applications for mail include RF leakage testing and being worn as a Faraday cage suit by Tesla coil enthusiasts and high-voltage electrical workers. Conventional textile-based ballistic vests are designed to stop soft-nosed bullets but offer little defense from knife attacks. Knife-resistant armor are designed to defend against knife attacks. Some of these use layers of metal plates, mail and metallic wires. Many historical reenactment groups, especially those whose focus is antiquity or the Middle Ages, commonly use mail both as practical armor and for costuming. Mail is especially popular amongst those groups which use steel weapons. A modern hauberk made from 1.5 mm diameter wire with 10 mm inner diameter rings weighs roughly and contains 15,000 to 45,000 rings. One of the drawbacks of mail is the uneven weight distribution. The stress falls mainly on shoulders. Weight can be better distributed by wearing a belt over thmail, which provides another point of support. Mail worn today for reenactment and recreational use can be made in a variety of styles and materials. Most recreational mail today is made of butted links, which are galvanized or stainless steel. This is historically inaccurate but is much less expensive to procure and especially to maintain than historically accurate reproductions. Mail can also be made of titanium, aluminium, bronze, or copper. Riveted mail offers significantly better protection ability as well as historical accuracy than mail constructed with butted links. Riveted mail can be more labor-intensive and expensive to manufacture. Japanese mail, kusari, is one of the few historically correct examples of mail being constructed with such butted links. Mail remained in use as a decorative and possibly high-status symbol with military overtones long after its practical usefulness had passed. It was frequently used for the epaulets of military uniforms. It is still used in this form by the British Territorial Army. Mail has applications in sculpture and jewelry, especially when made out of precious metals or colorful anodized metals. Mail artwork includes headdresses, decorative wall hangings, ornaments, chess sets, macrame, and jewelry. For these non-traditional applications, hundreds of patterns, commonly referred to as weaves, have been invented. Large linked mail is occasionally used as a fetish clothing material, with the large links intended to reveal, in part, the body beneath them. In some films, knitted string spray painted with a metallic paint is used instead of actual mail in order to cut down on cost, an example being Monty Python and the Holy Grail, which was filmed on a very small budget. Films more dedicated to costume accuracy often use ABS plastic rings, for the lower cost and weight. Such ABS mail coats were made for the Lord of the Rings film trilogy, in addition to many metal coats. The metal coats are used rarely because of ear weight, except in close-up filming where the appearance of ABS rings is distinguishable. A large-scale example of the ABS mail used in The Lord of the Rings can be seen in the entrance to the Royal Armouries Museum in Leeds in the form of a large curtain bearing the logo of the museum. It was acquired from the makers of the film's armor, Weta Workshop, when the museum hosted an exhibition of Weta armor from their films. For the film Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, Tina Turner is said to have worn actual mail and she complained how heavy this was. Game of Thrones makes use of mail, notably during the Red Wedding scene. Typically worn under mail armor. Can be worn over mail armor. Others. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.